The call was made by Patrick Birungi, the executive director of Uganda Development Corporation, while appearing before Parliament's Finance Committee that is scrutinizing a motion by the Ministry of Finance seeking parliamentary approval to inject 200 billion shillings to bail out Roko Construction Company Limited. Birungi blamed the Ministry of Finance for failing to avail funds for the exercise for the audit.
There is need to do more work. When I said we need to do verifications of creditors, I said we need to, before the intervention is paid. Okay?
He also revealed that Uganda Development Corporation undertook an assessment on the gearing ratio of Roko and found that the company is highly indebted and not worth investment, and therefore called for thorough audit.
What we need to do is an assessment, first of all, on creditors and see whether the credit lines are supported by all the documents and therefore how they come up with the creditors that they are going to pay under this intervention.
The quick assessment report that you used to come up with, to make you think that actually Roko was stressed. And really, financially speaking, there is no way you can be subjective. There's no way you can be subjective about stress.
Okay, now let us allow him to respond. Yeah.
However, Birungi emphasized the need to bail out Roko Construction, citing the company's skyrocketing debt, which if not settled, will impact on the operations of the banking sector.
And that is my argument. And Honorable Chair, we were invited to give our opinion. And we have given our opinion.
Okay, Honorable Chan.
MPs asked the government to explain how the figure 207 billion shillings was reached upon without due diligence.
I want him to tell us how did he come up with a figure of 207.
I've already asked you that.
Yeah, that 207 here is able to when you give it to this company, it will come back to life.
Was requested to make an evaluation of Roko so that it enables government to take a decision in investing in Roko as directed by the president. So when he came, he said no, they could not do the evaluation because their immediate assessment indicated that Roko was highly distressed or highly stressed. The gearing ratio was very high. What do we mean by that? That it has more debts in comparison to equity. And they felt that unless government comes in and bails out Roko, that's when they can go and maybe do the evaluation. But of course, the committee rejected that. And they said, you need to do your work as directed. So he gave in some other reason and said that finance had not given the money to carry out that.
Committee members were left wondering how the bailout will revive Roko after UDC disclosing that the company is ailing like a patient in intensive care.
A lot of things has come out and we have been on a losing hand. These issues of Roko wanting public financing, wanting the government to finance them, I personally would not agree with that. Looking at the experiences that we have gone through. First of all, look at Atiak. Atiak sugar cane in Acholi. This lady Amina came. The government invested in money. At the moment as I talk, production is not taking place.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.